Yeah, you know, fire almost happened, and I put it out. I wasn't afraid. I stood in the pocket. I looked downfield.
Javonte's got it. He gets by Slay to the pylon. Touchdown!
Man, I'm not afraid. Some people would have called the fire department, not me. We're going to be eating patty melts. No fire, no insert, you know?
I love just balling with the boys, dude.
Balling with the boys, battling.
There's nothing better.
You guys are great.
When your own Patrick Henry said liberty or death, and George Washington got the cannons out, and all the rest of them that you taught me to worship as my heroes, they were fighters, they were warriors. But now when the time comes for our freedom, you want to reach back in the bag and grab somebody who's nonviolent and peaceful and forgiving and long-suffering. I don't go for that. Whoa.
Yeah, I just thought I'd express myself and tell my story a little bit, both musically and in the kitchen. So today, we're going to be doing episode 2. And honestly, I didn't think anyone was going to watch the last video. So the fact that we had all that support was great. I did read the comments, though, and...
Everybody want to know what I would do if I didn't win. I guess we'll never know.
Patty melt is sort of like a little grilled cheese. Had a beautiful baby with a cheeseburger. You got some rye bread. You got a little bit of Swiss cheese, a little bit of cheddar, patty, and caramelized onions. And there you have it. So we're gonna get started. All right. Caramelizing onions takes about 25 minutes usually. Just do it low and slow. You want to get as much golden sort of caramelization you can possibly get. It really sort of balances out the sandwich in a nice way. You do want to save a little bit of onion though for later, and you're going to chop up the onion in two ways. So you're going to do a very thin dice, and that's going to be mixed in with the patty. The rest of the onion that you have is going to be cut into thin slices, and that it's got to be thin because it's not going to caramelize as evenly if you have really big chunks, okay?
Frankly, how hard I go at it in the gym, they said, can we just pay you? And I said, sure.
Is that an icky onion?
Definitely not. Definitely not, dude.
Okay, so this is what you want to do. You want to cut it in half like this. And then little slices like this. All right, let's start to caramelize some onions. Pretty easy. You're just going to turn on your stove. You need a cast iron. If not, an Abio cook set is going to be great. The nonstick pans are superb. But yeah, so you just need about 2 tablespoons of vegetable oil, and you're on your way.
Where was most of the work focused at today?
I think the onions take probably the most time. You know, I think if you don't get those right, then you just kind of have like a regular hamburger. So if you really get the onions going, you're going to have the most rich, fulfilling, fully vegan hamburger you could possibly have. So
we're going to work our onions in there. They're nice and thin cut. That'll be perfect. Spread them out. And so you're just going to basically be sipping your White Claw and Hornitos and doing a little stir action.
Wrist, 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 wrist. Never had to whip a brick, but I get the gist.
Okay, here we go. All right, we got the onions going. They're gonna take their time. You might want to stir it every now and then. That's okay, you know? It's okay. What we're gonna do, we gotta form our patties. So we got a few things we gotta do.
That's my next question.
Yeah.
Less patty, more melt? Or more melt and less patty?
more patty or more melt. I think it's the perfect blend of the two. If you have more of one and less of the other, then I mean, I think you're in trouble. 80-20 meat. 80% lean, 20% fat. A pound should be fine. And you're just gonna literally just throw it in a bowl, right? Then what you want, you're gonna get your ketchup and your garlic. Garlic powder, granulated garlic powder. You want about a tablespoon of ketchup. It's about a tablespoon, maybe a little more. And a pinch of garlic powder.
Work that into meat. Give your meat a good old rub.
On meat patties, I'm sorry. I didn't know.
I'm really fucking hungry and this needs to chop chop.
Babe, wait. Come on, I didn't realize.
Okay. Get to work.
Yeah, so this is a slightly different way to prepare an onion. We did this in our last episode, but I'll show you again. So this isn't going to be a chop, this is going to be a dice. You want to do it really thin. The onion's just supposed to give the, you're going to mix the onion into the patty. And it just gives it a little bit of crunch and a little bit of freshness, which I think is really nice. You want to get really thin with the slices. You're going to go like this. Across. You don't need the whole onion. I would say about maybe like a quarter cup, so that's probably more than enough. And then you're gonna go crosswise underneath, right? Then here, all you gotta do is this. Just gonna take these beautiful little pieces of onion, throw them in your bowl, all right? Now this is where it gets a little dirty. You're gonna get your hands a little dirty. You're gonna do a little massaging, like that. Might have a little ketchup on your
hand. Sir!
That's all right, you know.
What's the ketchup?
The ketchup just gives it, I don't know, it's like that classic burger sort of diner feel. It's just good.
I gotta get her back. I can't let nobody else hit that. I'm gonna tell her if she's gonna be single, she gotta leave that cat with me.
The granulated garlic, I think, gives it a little bit more depth. You always need salt and pepper with everything, man. And it's not a fancy burger, man. It's just supposed to be a classic sort of diner style thing. So nothing fancy. You don't need any of the like sirloin cuts or none of that. Just your good old-fashioned chuck. And there you go. It should look like this, right? And then all you're going to do is you're going to make little patties out of it. Should be about, I don't know, maybe a quarter inch thick. Don't want to pat them up too much because then, you know, it's not going to be as tender. But you don't want to be flopping around either. You don't want them to be too loose. So about something like that, you know? Something like that. Oh yeah. And I'm just gonna do another one. You know, I've for many years I've trained my hands in the ways of martial arts. You know? So stuff like this could be tiring for some people. You know, you gotta work up. Making patties all day is tough. Yeah. People say you shouldn't put raw meat on a cutting board because there's parasites, but those aren't real, okay? Parasites aren't real, okay? I don't even wash my hands after I cook. I really don't. So it's been about 18-20 minutes. The onions are ready to go. Just gonna set those aside. Yeah, they should. Yeah, look at all that. Look at all that. Woo. Put it right in your bowl. Set it aside. These are gonna go on the patties once they're ready. We gotta cook the patties in the same cast iron that we were cooking the onions in. Just means more flavor. It'll be perfect. You got all that oil and caramelization that's sticking to the bottom of the pan. That's fine. We want that. So what we're gonna do, put a little bit more oil in there. A good mix of oil and butter is really nice. The butter just gives it some flavor, but it does have a lower cooking temperature. When you mix that with a vegetable oil or an olive oil, you're gonna have a higher cooking consistency, but you're also, it'll allow you to get a little bit more color on the burger. So I'll show you how to do that. little bit of olive oil, vegetable oil, I'm sorry. Throw your butter in. Let it melt. Then let's get to fucking cooking, man. Ooh. 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 You can dance. There's no problem with that. I checked the rule book. You're allowed to dance.
Oh, say less.
Baby, it's okay. You just want that cake. I just want that cake.
We're getting a little color on the first side. We'll flip them in just a second. I'm going to take a look at one of them. Oh, yeah, there we go. It's flip zone. Patties are ready. Just going to plop them down on a plate. Got a little bit of color there, which is good. But they're still pink inside. And that's what you want. If you if you know anybody that likes their steaks or burgers well done, they might be a narc. Okay, so just
steaks and burgers well done.
Well, then are you a narc? Well, you can't tell
probably.
Me.
You like your burgers well done?
Definitely.
That's a
steak and burgers well done.
Dude, that's a mistake. That's a mistake. That's a mistake. Yeah. Oh, that wasn't even planned. That wasn't even planned. That's a mistake. You know what? Yeah, we're done. We're done. We're
no mistakes here.
So I think Levi's, Levi's rye bread. It's real Jewish rye, as they say. That's their slogan. This is the bread you want to use. I think it's good because it's the right. It's got a good size. It can fit the patty just right. Looks like this. You know. And we're gonna do a little assembling action here, all right? So, here's what you're gonna wanna do. You're gonna start with cheddar. Gonna start with some cheddar. You put that on the bottom. Then you're gonna put your burger on. Then you're gonna put your caramelized onions on, yeah. Oh my God, this is gonna be so good, man. Okay, then you wanna put your Swiss cheese on, baby. With little holes in them. See? You wanna put your Swiss cheese in there. Right on top, okay? Little couple slices of Swiss cheese will be perfect. Okay. Then what you're gonna do, you're gonna put it on top. Now this is the funny part, okay? When you wanna get the most crispy grilled cheese ever, you need mayonnaise, not butter.
Hey yo, what the fuck?
Just put this beautiful thing on top. Right? And what you wanna do, you wanna weigh it down, right? You can use just like a pot or a pan. You know, a brick maybe, I don't know. And you're gonna put it on top. All right, we're flipping it. Gotta get some mayonnaise on that. You know, get that Christmas on both sides.
How'd you know it was mayo instead of butter? I really wanna know that. I ain't never heard that shit.
My father told me, and his father before him.
And if your dad, they said, oh, it doesn't matter whether you win or lose, just as long as you have fun. Well, I hate to say it, your dad's a loser.
I'll take two of those to go.
Just
It's really good. I'm sorry, I got a little carried away there. I'm a musician, so you know. Burger's cooked to perfection. Still got some pink. The cheeses go really nicely, but the onion really sort of balances the whole thing out. You got some sweetness, got some salt, got the crisp from the bread. The rye has its own, you know, specific flavor it gives to it. I mean, man, this is all you could ask for on a Sunday, so I'm grateful. And yeah, make sure you give it a try.
Her favorite spot is Turkey Lit Hut. She eat it and pray that it go to her butt. She said that she vibing with me, but our lifestyles won't sync up. Well, break my heart if you must. Step on it, turn it into dust. Technically, I'm still your crush. Technically, can we still fuck up?